listen to this video, it is going to open your ears, it is going to open many things in your life. Failing to control the tongue. Failing to control the tongue. Many people, they fail to control the tongue. What does that mean? The tongue. The tongue. Your tongue. Your tongue. Failing to control your tongue. Let's look in the scripture. Let me pray that God will help you. Nothing will strike, nothing will come to interfere with this meeting, with this prayer. My Father, in the name of Jesus, I commit this message to you. I pray, oh God, my Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, I commit this message to you, Lord. I pray for the family, the people of Periscope. I pray for everyone that will listen this prayer. Lord, would deliver them and their family, God. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Lord, cover this prayer with your precious blood. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, my God and my Father, I want to thank you and I give you all the glory. Thank you, Father. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. I'm going to read to you the book of Luke 1, verse 18 to 21. The book of Luke 1, 18 to 21. The tongue, what messes up a priest. His own tongue make a priest to lose his job as a priesthood. A priest who was worshiping God, who believed God, who trusted God, a priest in the New Testament, a priest by the name called Zechariah. Zechariah was from the priesthood, and his wife was also from the priesthood. Both of them, they were priests. And now here is a man who was in the synagogue, who was in the altar of God, in the temple, in the sanctuary of God. He didn't know how to use his tongue properly. Let's look what the Bible says. The Bible says in the book of Luke 1, 18 to 21, the Bible says, Zechariah said to the angel, how can I be sure this would happen? I am an old man now, and my wife is also well long in years. When the angel was talking with Zechariah, Zechariah started questioning angel. He said, how can be sure this would happen? The angel was very angry with Zechariah. The angel was almost slapped Zechariah. When Zechariah opened his mouth with his tongue to say that, then the angel said, I am Gabriel. I stand in the very presence of God. The angel introduced him that is Gabriel and is presence of God. He's standing with his presence of God. Still, Zechariah could not get it. Still, Zechariah did not respond all say, what? After introduction, even the angel introduced him, he said, Zechariah, listen, I am the angel of God, and I stand in the very presence of God. It was he who sent me to bring you this good news. It is God who has favored you, who had heard your prayer. He has sent me to deliver you this message. The angel was negotiating and talking to Zechariah, but Zechariah did not do anything. Still was unbelieving. He didn't believe what the angel was talking. It is the same thing that happened to many people. The angel said, but now, since you did not believe what I said, you will be silenced and unable to speak until the child is born. For my words would certainly be fulfilled at the proper time. Now, because the angel was still watching Zechariah to see if Zechariah would respond positive, but Zechariah did not believe the angel. You know, the Bible is very clear and it does not change or revise. The Bible says, now, because of that, you will be silenced. You will not use your tongue again. Now, nobody will hear you now. You will be silenced until the child will be born. Because of that, the angels told Zechariah, From today, at this minute, you will not open your mouth. Your tongue will be sheep. Your mouth will be sheep. You will never open again to talk. Now, meanwhile, the people were waiting to Zechariah to come out of the sanctuary, wondering why he was taking so long. So the people were waiting because Zechariah was going to the sanctuary, Hall of Holes, to pray to people and to speak to God. Now, when the people waited so long, they suspected maybe something has happened to him. Because in the sanctuary, sometimes you can be killed there by God. When you go there, it's not a joke. It's not like now people choking with the sanctuary, with the church of God. The Hall of Holes, the sanctuary where the priest used to go, is a very holy place. You cannot go with sin and then you come alive there. So the Bible says that the people were waiting, what is going on? When Zechariah came out, he was not talking. He was silent. He could not talk. He only write signs. Then the people knew that he has visited by the angel. Because people knew that if you visited by the angel and you rebel, the angel will not let you go. It can even kill you. The angel itself can destroy you. Hallelujah. Let's look in the book of Exodus 23 verse 1. Let's look in the book of Exodus 23 verse 21. The book of Exodus 23 verse 21. The Bible says, be on your guard before him and obey his voice. Do not rebel towards him, for he will not abandon your transgression, since my name is in him. God warned the children of Israel. He said, do not rebel against the angel. Do not rebel against my angel. Do not rebel against my angel. If you rebel, because this is the angel I'm sending, it's my message, and my presence is there. My name is there. So this angel cannot forgive you. He cannot forgive you. He cannot abandon you. Now, when you provoke the angel is not, because it's a messenger. He has been sent to you to produce to give you good news, like what he brought to Zechariah. Zechariah was an old man, and his wife was also old. They were expecting to get a baby. They've been praying and doing everything, fasting, and praying that God will give them a child. Now the good news has come. Still, Zechariah, of all the people, was asking a question, asking about what would happen. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. My God, I want to thank you that God, let no one be a portion that would question the angel. Personally, when I was sick, depressed, I didn't know what to do. I was a minister. I had my own ministry. I was sick and things were running, were scattered. I was not able to have anything. I was praying and I said, God, if there's any way that you can reveal to me, show me what to do. God sent me an angel. If I rebelled the angel, I could not be here today. And now this angel, when he was talking to me, because he came to me like he was really the person you cannot talk to. Now I look at him, I said, what is this man talking to me? I was very angry with him in my spirit, but he continued talking to me like 3 times. Now, after 3 times, I said, let me listen. I think this person has a sense. He has a meaning here. He knows what I'm looking for. So he's the one who delivered me. He gave me this deliverance ministry. I was not given by human being. It is God of our forefathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. That's why I'm telling you, when I come to your life, I am sent by God to help you. I don't play games. I don't joke. I'm not here to show myself. Or I'm not here because I need your tithe and offering. Or I'm not here because I need your money or anything. I want to help you. You know, I went through so much difficult life until the Lord revealed to me this deliverance. I was not given. Nobody told me what I know and what I'm telling you. God is my witness. I didn't know nobody. I didn't have anybody to tell me what I'm telling you. You are lucky and you have to receive this message. That's why I've told you that this message, you share to your friends, you share to your fellows, pass it to your medias, even take it anywhere and give it to them. Because you will provoke the angels without your knowledge. One of the greatest cause of short life is the tongue. One of the greatest causes of short life is the tongue. The tongue can make you to cut your life short, because you can speak the word, and this word would be make the angels or make whatever is responsible and kill you. It will cut you into pieces. Life, this is not spiritual. You will take your life because of your tongue. Instead of reasoning and saying, yes, let this be, and listening and responding. But now, you start murmuring, you start questioning, you don't respond, then it will kill you, it will destroy you, it will deny you good things. People of God, if it were possible to padlock the mouth of human beings, a lot of people could have not been, have died. When they die, many have gone into bondage because of their tongue. Most times, you just have to keep quiet. That's the time you have to keep quiet. You have to shut your mouth and look at things. Most of the time, it is better to reason. If your tongue has no control and you can speak 500 words per minute, even 2,000 words per minute, then you are writing an invitation of short life, because you don't know what you are saying. You don't give your permission. So the more you talk so much words, the more you invite the open doors for the devil to come and start fighting you. Talk slowly and think. Don't open doors for the enemy to come and destroy you. Not even the enemy, messenger of God. God can send you a messenger. All the word which will help, which will deliver you. Because you talk so much, you talk, then you miss. Some people can talk and abuse an angel of God without knowledge that the fellow they are taking. You can abuse the angel without knowing. And the angel, as the Bible has warned us, don't provoke the angel. They cannot forgive you. The angel will damage you and even kill you. Because it's the messenger who has been sent, and God is with them. The presence of God is there, and the name of God is with that angel. They are not the angel, they are not human beings that you can negotiate and talk with them. When Daniel was in trouble, when he got this dream, he didn't know what to do. Gabriel has to go there and help him and interpret him. So Gabriel, this is the angel Gabriel who went to Daniel. And it's the same angel who went to Zechariah. It appears in the book of God, in the book of Daniel and the book of Luke. How the angel went and helped Daniel. When Daniel didn't know what to do, the angel went and helped him. So this angel has been sent to help you. So if you misuse your tongue, you will abuse the angel without knowing. Yes. Hallelujah. And they end up inviting curses, because angels does not operate like us. Angels does not operate like us. Please, some people can talk and abuse an angel of God without knowing that the fellow they are talking to is an angel of God. And they end up inviting curses because angels does not operate like us. Angels of God does not operate like us. Remember, the book of Acts that says it's not like us. It cannot forgive you. Yeah? It's not for, like, you can't tolerate, you can't talk nonsense. The Bible has warned us. You cannot lie. They don't tolerate indiscipline, and they can be easily provoked. That's why God warned the Israelites, I would place my angels before you to go on the way that you will go, but hint that you do not provoke him. If you do, he would not abandon you. Do not provoke him, because he does not understand the word please. The angel does not understand the word bliss. The angel did not forgive Zechariah when he doubted him and said, "Can these things be? I'm old and my wife is advanced in age." The angel said, "I am Gabriel. I came from the throne of God to give you this message, and you are talking rubbish." The angel told Zechariah, "I came from the throne of God, and now you are talking rubbish. After praying that God has answered your prayer, now you are talking rubbish. Your rubbish will make you to suffer for 9 months without opening your mouth. You will not speak to anybody." Zechariah went in deep discipline. Don't wait God to discipline you. Don't be person who is easily provoking the angel of God. It's better you keep quiet. All you say, like Mary says, Mary visited, the angel Gabriel visited Mary. And Mary said, "Let it be the way you have said." Mary was a virgin. She was engaged with a man who was going to marry her. And here is the angel who said that she's going to be pregnant. What do you think? What do you think that one? "I am a virgin. I have someone who is going to marry me. How would the world know? How would himself would take it if I give birth through the Holy Spirit? What disgrace would I bring to my family?" But Mary said, "Let it be done according to your word." Mary responding to the angel Gabriel, and then it happened without trouble. Yes? And then the boyfriend, the fiancé, the boyfriend of Mary, he was like doubting a little bit. That's why we don't see him more in the Bible. Because he was saying, "Mary, tell me the truth. How did you conceive?" She explained to Mary, to Joseph, the father of Jesus. But he believed, but according to research and what we know, after Jesus went to the temple and said that, I am doing the business of my father, so Joseph didn't like that. He didn't like that because he said, "Mary, now I believe you have another husband. Why is your son talking like this?" But from there, you don't hear Joseph anymore. We don't know God killed him or what happened to him. You see, your tongue can kill you, can destroy you. When Gabriel came to give them good news, you don't have to provoke the angels of God. Somebody is asking, "How do I know this is the angel of God?" You will know. You will know it's the angel of God. Automatically, if you are a righteous person, you are praying God, you are been trusting God for good things, he sends angels, you will know. Hallelujah. For that, you should be damned. He had to lose his mouth and send him on a compulsory holiday. The angels of God has to send Zechariah compulsory holiday, not to talk for 9 months. The tongue has killed so many people. I pray that the Lord will deliver us from the trap of the tongue in the name of Jesus. I pray that God will deliver us from the tongue in the name of Jesus. My God and my Father, I want to thank you, Lord. I pray that God deliver our tongues. The tongue has killed so many people. I pray that the Lord will deliver us from the trap of the tongue in the name of Jesus. We have so many scriptures we can look into. If you look at the 1 Peter 3 verse 10, 1 Peter 3 verse 10, the Bible says, "For he that will love life, for he that will love life and see good days, let him restrain his tongue from evil and his lips that are guile." You have to stay from speaking lies, telling lies, cunning. You don't play with your tongue games. It will destroy you. I'm telling you, this is what it is. You don't play games with your tongue. Be serious. The Bible says, "For he that love life," if you love your life, if you love life, "and see good days, and see good days, let him restrain from his tongue from evil." Restrain from evil. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. God is good. God loves us and he warns us and he tells us what to do. He gives us a warning. But because of no reason, you start misusing your tongue and you think that it would be good for you. God does not tolerate rubbish. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, you are a great God. Now you see here, let me repeat in another translation. The Bible says, for the scripture says, if you want to enjoy life and see many happy days, keep your tongue from speaking evil and your lips from telling lies. Keep your tongue from speaking evil and your lips from telling lies. Do you know many people that speak evil, they use their tongue speaking evil? You will cut your life short. You are telling your life, I'm driving to hellfire, to the grave. Because the Bible tells us in the book of Proverbs 18 verse 21, death and life are in the power of the tongue, and they that love it shall eat the fruit of thereof. Listen, hallelujah, my God, my Father, I want to thank you, Jesus. I bless your name, God. I give you all the glory, my God. My Father, I attack every power of the tongue. I command every serpent and scorpion that has been programmed in your tongue. I command that tongue to be healed in the name of Jesus. I am speaking the word of the living God. You that tongue, hear the word of God. Be healed. Let your tongue catch fire and destroy every word, every lies, anything programmed in that tongue. Let it catch fire and burn to ashes. Every dragon that is messing you, that is making you to talk and abuse the angels of God, it will kill you. Let the fire of God enter in your mouth and deliver you in Jesus' name. I pray that God Almighty wash your mouth, wash your tongue, wash your teeth in the name of Jesus. Your lips shall be delivered. Let your lips be delivered in Jesus' name. Look at the man who had a bad mouth. He was he was not able to control his mouth. But because he knew that if he can ask help from God, God will deliver him. This is the man called Prophet Isaiah. Prophet Isaiah, he knew that his mouth is bad. He had bad tongue. Bad tongue and bad mouth, bad lips. So he went when King Hosea died, Isaiah got opportunity to lure, because King Hosea praised him so much. But he was praised because his mouth was bad, because he was talking rubbish and he was not humble himself. That's why the king has praised him and put him down. He said, Isaiah, you cannot rise up unless I die. So when this man died is when Isaiah rose up and thank God. He said, thank you, Lord. Now use me, but my mouth is bad. I don't want to go to punishment. I don't want to say things that I'm not supposed to say. Heal me. Then the Bible says in the book of Isaiah 6, verse 5, the Bible says, then said, I woe in me, for I am undone, because I am a man of unclean lips, and I dwell in the midst of people of unclean lips. For my eyes have seen the King, the Lord of hosts. So the Isaiah say, I'm undone. I live in wicked people, people who like to curse people. So I have adapted this. Please, God, I have seen you. Help me deliver my tongue. You can live in people, a place, an environment where people are talking careless, talking evil, cursing. So you adapt that. So Isaiah cried to God and said, God, I'm undone. My lips, my tongue. I live in the midst of evil people, satanic people, people who does not fear you, who curses, who use their tongue in the wrong way. So Isaiah asked God help. And the Bible says the angels of God, Salaphans, he came and helped him. He had live fire and he put his mouth. And this man, that's how he was, his tongue was healed. And he started talking properly. So your tongue can be healed. Zerubbabel will bring his fire onto your mouth and heal your tongue. in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, my God, my Father, God who healed Isaiah's tongue, his lips, he will appear to you and heal you in the name of Jesus Christ. My Father, I pray that our tongue cannot fail. Our tongue cannot fail us. By the power in the blood of Jesus, I plead the blood of Jesus, God. My Father and my God, let our tongue give us good life. Let our tongue bring things that will not kill us. In the mighty name of Jesus, I plead the blood of Jesus over our tongues. My tongue shall be healed. Let your tongue be healed in Jesus' name. Ask the Holy Spirit to heal your tongues. If you are a person who talks careless, me, I used to talk careless. I used to say anything I want to say. But because of this, when I started learning about how to control my tongue, I said, my tongue, you will not control me. I will not fail. Many people who do not understand me, they condemn me, they judge me, because I know that I'm talking the truth and I'm doing the right thing. Because of that, the people, they run away. And I look at this, I said, Lord, I've not done anything wrong to these people. Yeah? Being a prophet, being a prophetic in the ministry, sometimes when the Holy Spirit gives you something, people get offended easily and they just go. And you want to help them. You want to help them. Because of they get offended easily and they use the word you have said against you to condemn you, to judge you, then these people ending up in a pathetic way. I've seen so many people, when God gave me a word to help them, like when God was talking to Zechariah, Zechariah was challenging the angels, but the angel said, you will see who is who. Yeah? The word of God is power. When the word of come out of the mouth of the prophet, a mouth of a woman of God, receive it and humble yourself. It will correct you and help you. But because you are rebellious, you know the Bible says, Exodus, that the angels will not forgive your transgression, will not forgive your sins. Your sins, if the angel has authority to forgive and go, but because you rebel against it, if you refuse to obey the word of the prophet that is warning you, look at the prophet called Jeremiah. When Jeremiah told the prophet, that the children of Israel will be captured, will be taken to exile, if you cannot surrender yourself to God, to Nebuchadnezzar. The prophet was angry. He didn't obey, but at the end, they were captured and they were being taken for 450 years. I'm telling you that it is better when the word of God comes to you, listen and receive it and ask God mercy. When the book of John, when they never was going to burn to ashes, God sent John. John went, refused, and they said, God, I know you are a massive God. You are the one to change your mind, and you can't do, because I know those people. Then John was very angry. He refused to go, and he was swallowed by the whales, by the fish, to make sure that God does not joke. He sent a man, he sent a prophet there, and when the never people heard about the prophecy, they tear their clothes, they went to pray and fasting, asking God for mercy, and God favored them and forgive them. So God can still forgive you. God can still favor you. God can still appear to you and deliver you. When he sent his message, don't reject the message of God. Don't let your tongue to fail you and miss important gift or an important thing or a blessing. That's how it works. Many people, they miss blessings every day. And then you start crying. I've been praying, I've been doing this. When did you sit down? You know, I was saying that sit down with God and Jesus. Talk. Give God time. Spend time with God, with his presence. You will see, you build a good relationship with him. And then you will ask anything in his name, he will do it for you. My God, I thank you and I bless you. I give you all the glory. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. I give you all the honor and glory. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. This message, I have to stop here. I will continue next time. I don't know when I will come for Periscope, but for now, after Thursday, I will come 4 o'clock. If I come in between, I don't know. But I will be coming 4 o'clock until Thursday. Thursday is 8 o'clock in the morning. So this one will be 4 o'clock. Thank you very much. God bless you. Have a wonderful time, people of God. And I know that control your tongue. Don't let your tongue to fail you. Don't let your tongue to fail you. Don't lose the blessings of God because of your tongue. Remember to take care of your tongue. It will give you the long life. If you don't take your tongue properly, it will kill you. Therefore, people of God, I thank you so much. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Isiki, saying bye-bye to you. See you tomorrow, 4 o'clock, or on any time I want to come in, but my time, usually my official time for now, is 4 o'clock. God bless you so much. Have a wonderful time. Thank you. Bye-bye.